SRAM, the end goal is to deliver cycling components that inspire the rider and make the bicycle faster. We started this project with Autodesk as a leader in generative design technology so that we could pair that with what we understand about bicycle design and look at optimizing our crankarm designs.
What we're doing is utilizing artificial intelligence as well as supercomputing power allows you to come up with dozens or hundreds of different designs that no human could ever think of, and you're getting those in a fraction of the time.
We chose the crankarm for this generative design project because it's a large structural member.
We took their past crankarms as inspiration, and we use our design exploration software called Generative Design inside of Fusion 360. You have to bring in new design tools to think differently and do things differently. And what you're gonna do is you're gonna use innovation as the key to bring in the new methods of creating and manufacturing your products.
From the digital idea to the physical element, additive manufacturing can help get you there quicker. Allows us to bring the idea into physical space, evaluate it, test it, ride it, then go back and decide what elements of the design we want to put into our production drivetrain. For SRAM, the end goal is to deliver cycling components that inspire the rider and make the bicycle faster. And generative design is a tool that is allowing us to not only optimize performance parameters for the rider, for the cyclist, but also shorten our development time to try new ideas, evaluate them, throw them out, or give them more merit and bring them to the prototype phase. Then we're able to deliver those new ideas quicker to the end user. At SRAM, we're an innovation company, and so as we look to inspire the consumer with our components, we want to continually add innovation and make that riding experience better. And generative design is helping us get to that finish line quicker.